गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम वेयर वी लेफ्ट इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर। वेरियस ज्योमेट्रिक ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑपरेशंस, सो दीज आर द सिक्स इंपॉर्टेंट ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑपरेशंस और ज्योमेट्रिक ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑपरेशंस। फर्स्ट इज अ ट्रांसलेशन। With the help of translation, we can perform or we can move the geometry along x-axis and along y-axis with a distance or translation distance tx and ty. Second is a rotation. If you want to rotate the geometry in clockwise direction or in anti-clockwise direction in a coordinate system, the transformation operation is called as a rotation. Third one is a scaling. If you want to enlarge or reduce the size of the geometry, then scaling transformation is used. Then reflection or mirror. If you want to perform a mirror or reflection of a geometry about x-axis, about y-axis, about minus x, about minus y, or about a line y is equal to mx plus c, etc. Then next we have a shear operation. That operation is used to slant the image or geometry along x-axis or along y-axis. That is called as x-shear and y-shear. Next, we have a composite transformation. That is nothing but a concatenated transformation, which is nothing but a combination of any two or more type of transformation out of five transformation. So, that is called as a composite or combination of transformations. In previous session, we discussed about translation when every entity of geometric model remains parallel to its initial position, then such a transformation is called as a translation. Then we consider one point P in XY coordinate system or two-dimensional coordinate system whose coordinates are X and Y. Now, we want to translate this point P by a distance tx in x direction and ty in y direction. The translation matrix T, therefore, it is to be added in original matrix. The new point P dash would then have a new coordinates as a x dash and y dash. Then how this can be mathematically represented? Therefore, translation matrix is given as capital T is equal to matrix Tx and Ty. Therefore, x dash y dash, this is nothing but new position or the new point P dash with the coordinate x dash y dash is equal to original point coordinates in matrix form plus translation matrix, means new position of a point is achieved when we added the translation matrix in original position coordinates. So P dash is equal to P plus T. So automatically how it will be represented, a single coordinate x dash will be equal to x plus Tx and y dash is equal to y plus ty. So this is simply matrix addition operation. Okay, so in this way we can perform the translation transformation operation. Now this is for single point P in two dimensional coordinate system. If it is a line, then there will be a two end points p1 and p2. So P1 will be having coordinates x1, y1 and P2 will be having coordinates x2, y2. For that purpose, we have to form the matrix for line L is equal to matrix P1, P2. So that will be nothing but 2x2 matrix x1, y1 and x2, y2. Two row and two column matrix will be there for a line. Okay. Now this is one example how the translation is performed for a particular transformation. So this is a original line given in a xy coordinate system. So these are the coordinates. For example, this is a point P1 and this is point P2. So this will be x1, y1, 1, 1. This is a x2, y2. X2 is 3 and y2 is 2. After that, translation distance is given. Means this point P1, I want to translate in along x axis by a distance 2 units. So tx is equal to 2 is given and ty is equal to 2 is given. Means this point I want to transfer along y axis by 2 units. Means tx is equal to 2, ty is equal to 2. Now this tx and ty is applicable for p1 and p2 simultaneously. Okay, means this is not tx for p1 and ty for p2. This is tx and ty for p1 and tx and ty for p2. Okay, so it is added in original matrix tx ty. So if it is a point, it will be applicable for only x1, y1. If it is a p1, p2, then it will be applicable for or added automatically for x1, y1 and x2, y2. Now we will see one example how the transformation is performed. Now what is given? How the problem statement is given? So in problem statement, the coordinates of this geometry or this triangle is mentioned in the problem statement. Consider a triangle ABC having coordinates A 1 1, B 3 3 and C 4 1. The triangle is to be translated along x axis in 4 units and along y axis direction 2 units. Find new coordinates of translated triangle. So this is our problem statement. Okay, how the problem statement is there? A triangle ABC having coordinates A 1 1, B 3 3 and C 4 1 is to be translated by a distance 4 units in x direction and 2 units in y direction. Calculate, find out or determine the new coordinates of a translated triangle. Means we have to find out A dash, B dash, C dash. So based on this problem statement, what we have to do? We have to first form a matrix for a original triangle. So that is called as a ABC. Means this is point P1, this is P2 and this is P3. So the coordinates will be x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3. Now how that will be represented by 3 rows and 2 columns? Means this will be 3 by 2 matrix. So this is a coordinates of point A. These are the coordinates of point B and this is the coordinates of point C. So this will be x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3. So any point can be represented in a matrix form as a one row and two column. Means it will be for A, this is for B and this is for C. So this is our original triangle represented in matrix form for a coordinates. Okay. Next, what is given? Translation distance along x-x direction and translation distance along y direction is mentioned. So tx is equal to 4 units and ty is equal to 2 units. Now translation matrix is denoted by matrix tx ty. So this is a 4 and 2. So this is translation along x direction and translation along y direction. Now what is our formula for translation transformation operation? P dash is equal to P plus T. What is our formula? P dash is equal to P plus T. So P dash will be the new position. So that will be A dash, B dash, C dash. Then T will be the ABC matrix and T is the transformation, translation transformation matrix. So P dash is equal to P plus T. So that will be A dash, B dash, C dash is equal to A, B, C plus T. So putting the value of a matrix for A, B, C plus translation matrix. So this is simple matrix addition operation here. 1 plus 4, so that will be 5. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 4, 7. 3 plus 2, 5. Then 4 plus 4, 8. And 1 plus 2, 3. Means row and column addition. So we will get a new coordinates. A dash is equal to 5, comma 3. B dash is equal to 7, comma 5. And C dash is equal to 8 comma 3. After that, again we have to represent that new coordinates in the same coordinate system. So here A dash is a 5, A dash 5 and 3. So here it is a x 1 dash and y 1 dash, x 1 dash and y 1 dash. So that will be 5 and y is 3. Second, B dash 7 and 5, so that will be x2 dash and y2 dash. So here x coordinate for B dash is a 7 and y coordinate is a 5. Then C dash x3 dash and y3 dash, so that will be x3 dash is a 8, so here it is 8, and y3 dash is a 3. Okay. So this geometry is called as the original geometry, or it is also called as the original triangle. This geometry is called as a transform geometry, or it is also called as a translated triangle. So we can perform the translation transformation operation for a point, for a line. So this is for line, for example. This is for triangle. It can be performed for square. So that will be A, B, C, D, maybe pentagon, hexagon, etc. So up to square or rectangle, the problems will be there for translation transformation operation. Okay. So you have to move the geometry along x axis by a translation distance tx and along y axis by a translation distance ty. Okay, now second one is a rotation transformation operation. Now what is meant by rotation? It is an important transformation that allows the user to view the object from different angles. So rotation transformation is nothing but if any geometry or object is given, we can rotate that geometry in clockwise direction or in anti-clockwise direction, following the circular path. Okay. Now there is a two type of rotation is there. One is a counterclockwise or anticlockwise rotation. So that rotation we have to consider or assume it as a positive angle of rotation. Second one is a clockwise rotation. So that rotation we have to consider as a negative, that is nothing but minus theta. So this is just an assumption. We have to consider the angle of rotation in anticlockwise direction is positive theta. If it is a clockwise direction, it will be the negative theta. Means in XY coordinate system, if a particular geometry is given and if that geometry we have to rotate it in clockwise direction, then it will be a negative theta angle of rotation we have to consider. If it is in anti-clockwise direction or counter-clockwise direction, then we have to consider the positive theta for angle of rotation. Now we have to consider one point. Let us consider one point whose coordinates are x, y. In two-dimensional coordinate system, it is to be rotated by an angle theta about the origin. Okay. So what we consider? Simple xy coordinate system. In that xy coordinate system, we located one point P whose coordinates are x and y. Now what we have to do? We have to rotate that point P by an angle theta about origin O. So before a rotation operation, we must assume the conventions for the rotation or for viewing direction. If it is a counterclockwise, theta will be positive. If it is a clockwise, theta will be the negative. Now this is the figure showing the rotation of a point. So here it is point P. So initially we have a xy coordinate system. This is x axis, this is y axis, this is origin O. Now what is given? Point P is in xy coordinate system whose coordinates are small x and small y. Now what is r? R is the distance of point P or coordinates of point P from origin. R is the distance of coordinates of point P or position of point P from origin. Then phi. Here it is angle given phi. What is phi? Phi is the angle made by a position of point P with respect to horizontal axis x. Okay. Phi is the angle made by a position of a point P with respect to origin along x axis or along horizontal axis. So this is the original position angle for the point P whose coordinates are x and y. Now we have to find out the resolution of the forces for position of point P. So along x direction it will be x is equal to r cos of phi for this angle phi. X is equal to r cos of phi along x axis, and for y it will be y is equal to r sin of phi. For horizontal it will be r cos of phi, and for vertical along y axis it will be r sin of phi. So this is x and y distance along x axis and along y axis for a position of a point P with respect to angle phi. Now our objective is to rotate this point P from this position to this new position, which is a P dash. So x dash and y dash will be the new coordinates when this point P is rotated by an angle theta. So in counterclockwise direction. So here direction is mentioned counterclockwise or anticlockwise. So when we rotate the point P by an angle theta, which is additional angle for phi, phi plus now it will be theta along x axis, phi plus theta. So P dash will be the x dash y dash. So here again new coordinates for the P dash will be x dash and y dash, and horizontal and vertical distance is given as x dash is equal to r cos again theta plus, but it is a phi plus theta now as it is additional angle for P to P dash. So along x axis it will be phi plus theta or theta plus phi. So it may be called as a phi plus theta, or it is also called as a theta plus phi. So x dash is equal to r cos of theta plus phi for horizontal. For horizontal, here it is horizontal along x axis. Just like here we calculate x is equal to r cos of phi, same it is x dash is equal to r cos of angle. R cos of angle, but here angle is a phi plus theta now as P is rotated by a additional angle of theta. Now similarly for y, it will be y dash is equal to r sin of theta plus phi. R sin of theta plus phi. Here it is a r sin of phi along y axis, but now angle will be additional angle phi plus theta. So y dash is equal to r sine of theta plus phi. Now initially we have to represent this point P in matrix form. So P is equal to x matrix x and y. So this is representation of point P in matrix form. Coordinates P is equal to, now it is single point, so this will be one row and two column. So P is equal to simply x1 y1 or xy. Simply put the value of x and y here. So P is equal to x value is what? R cos of phi. So here r cos of phi. And y value is what? R sine of y. R sine of phi. So here it is r sine of phi. So matrix form, the point P can be represented as a matrix x, y. So that simply putting the value of x and y. So that will be x is equal to r cos of phi and y is equal to r sine of phi. So this is P is equal to r cos of phi space matrix form r sine of phi. Now when it is to be rotated by angle theta, then new position will be represented in matrix form as a P dash is equal to x dash y dash. Thus upon it P is equal to x y, here it will be P dash is equal to x dash y dash. Now putting the value of x dash and y dash, so here it will be x dash r cos of phi plus or theta plus phi, and y is y dash is r sine of theta plus phi. So same procedure is follow for P and P dash. Simply putting the value of x and y here and here x dash and y dash. Okay. Next, P dash is equal to, now what is operation is performed here? Cos A plus B formula. Cos A plus B, and here sin A plus B formula is used. Cos A plus B is what? Cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. Cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. Simple mathematical formula is used. Cos A plus B. So cos A plus B is simplified as cos A cos B sin A sin B. Means it will be cos theta cos phi minus sin theta sin phi. R is come out. इथे पण R काय आहे बाहेर आहे म्हणून R त्याच्या सोबत मल्टीप्लाय होणार आहे. फॉर दिस y डॅश कोऑर्डिनेट्स sin a plus b, सो दॅट विल बी sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. sin a cos b plus cos a sin b, सो दॅट विल बी R into sin theta cos theta cos phi plus cos theta sin phi. Now when we multiply this R two brackets, so it will be R cos theta cos phi minus R sin theta sin phi. When we multiply this R two bracket, it will be R cos of theta cos phi minus R sin of theta sin of phi. Similarly, when we multiply this R with the bracket, it will be R sin of theta cos of phi plus R cos of theta sin of phi. After that, we have a value of r cos of phi. What do you mean by r cos of phi? It is x. R cos of phi is what? X. R cos of phi x. So put the value of x here. Cos theta remains as it is. Minus r sin of phi is what? R sin of phi is what? Y. So here they use the r sin of phi as a y. Then sin theta remains as it is. Then here simply x and y again, the values of x and y from x and y, these values are used in this bracket after multiplication of r with the bracket. Simple mathematical calculation is there. So P dash is equal to, we will get this equation. So this can be expressed as matrix xy multiplied by cos of theta sin of theta minus sin of theta cos of theta. 2 by 2 matrix is there. So when we multiply this xy matrix with this cos theta sin theta matrix, it will again form the same equations. Means this equation can be written in this form also. Okay, same, both equations are same, only we write this equation another form. So P dash is equal to P into R. So this matrix is represented by capital R. So where R is equal to cos theta sin theta minus sin theta cos theta. So this is a P dash is equal to P into R. Just like in translation, P dash is equal to P plus T. Here P dash is equal to P into R, where R is the rotation transformation matrix, or it is a R is the rotation matrix. When multiplied to the original point, it achieves the rotation by angle theta about the origin. Means for any geometry coordinates are given, if we are using the rotation matrix and if we multiply that rotation matrix with the original matrix coordinates, then the rotation operation can be performed along the origin, means by angle of rotation theta. So you can note down this matrix, R is equal to cos theta sin theta minus sin theta and cos theta. So this is a derivation is there for getting the rotation transformation matrix. Very simple derivation, simple mathematical engineering mathematics knowledge or basic is used there for getting the rotation of a point or a geometry along origin or about origin by an angle of rotation theta. Now if P dash is rotated in clockwise direction, here if it is a P dash is equal to x dash y dash is somewhere here, there then there will be a minus theta we have to use. Cos of minus theta, sine of minus theta, minus sine of minus theta and cos of minus theta. Now one example on that, a line AB having coordinates A11 and B33 is rotated by a 90 degree in counterclockwise direction. Find new coordinates of rotated line. What is given in the problem statement? A line AB is given. Line AB is given whose coordinates are given A11, B33. Is rotated by or is to be rotated by 90 degree in counterclockwise direction, means this is angle of rotation theta in counterclockwise direction, means we have to consider theta positive. Find new coordinates of rotated line. So what we have to do, we have to again draw xy coordinate system. So this is x axis, this is y axis, this is origin. Now locate the a line AB as per given coordinates. So A will be 11 and B will be 3,3. So this is original position of the line in XY coordinate system. Now this part we don't have initially. When we have problem statement, we have only X and Y. We don't have this 50% part, negative side, we don't have. When we solve the problem, after that we will get this 50% part. So once the geometry is located, now form the matrix for that line AB. So this is AB, x1, y1, x2, y2. So this is 2 by 2 matrix, A, x1, y1 and B, x2, y2. Then R, rotation matrix, cos theta, sin theta, minus sin theta, cos theta. Cos theta, sin theta, minus sin theta, cos theta. This is our rotation matrix. Means original matrix is now AB and rotation matrix is a R. So we will get A dash B dash is equal to AB into R. Okay. A dash B dash is equal to AB into R, rotation matrix. So AB we form original matrix for line AB. So this will be 1, 1, 3, 3. Then rotation matrix, cos theta, sin theta, minus sin theta, cos theta. So theta will be a 90 degree as per given problem statement. Now direction, as per assumption, if it is counterclockwise or anticlockwise, we consider it as a positive. So theta is considered as a positive. So cos 90, sin 90, minus sin 90 and cos 90. So we putting the value of cos 90 sin 90 minus sin 90 and cos 90. After that matrix multiplication operation, first row, first column, first row, second column. So after that we will get minus 1, 1, minus 3, 3 as a new coordinates for end points of the line AB. So that will be A dash, B dash. So A dash we get as a minus 1 and 1, and B dash is a minus 3, 3. So now putting that values in our coordinate system. So here we as a two values are come as a negative. So we have to extend the x axis to in negative direction. So minus 1 and 1, minus 1 and y is again 1, y is positive. Then for x2, y2, x2 is again minus 3. So here it will be minus 3 x2. So x2 dash is minus 3 and y2 is again 3. So this will be the rotated line. So this is called as the original line AB, and this is called as a rotated geometry or rotated line. So automatically it will get the angle of rotation theta equal to 90 degree. So in this way we can perform the rotation transformation operation for a line. Sometimes a triangle is given, then it will be ABC. Rectangle is given, then it will be ABCD. Like this. This is square for translation transformation operation. This is for rotation. Triangle is given, PQR rotated by R is equal to 90 degree. Okay. So these types of problems will be there in next sessions. Okay, आपण बघणारच आहे पुढे. This is second transformation operation, rotation. Means we learn how to translate the line, that is called as a translation transformation operation. How to rotate the geometry about origin, that is called as a rotation transformation operation. Means if it is a translation, then simple formula is P dash is equal to P plus T. If it is a rotation, P dash is equal to P into R, where R is the rotation transformation matrix. R is the rotation transformation matrix. Okay. Next, third operation is a scaling operation. Now scaling is nothing but what? It is the transformation which enlarge or reduce the size of geometry. Means it changes or alters the size of object. Means if in XY coordinate system, in XY coordinate system, if one minute, so scaling is the transformation which enlarge or reduce the size of the geometry. It means in XY coordinate system, if a particular geometry is given, for example triangle is given, a rectangle is given, now what transformation I want to perform? I want to reduce the size of that geometry, or I want to enlarge the size of that geometry. Means that reducing or enlarging the size of the geometry can be performed by scaling operation. Now what is meant by scaling? There are two types of scalings are there. Scaling can be uniform type or can be non-uniform type. So there will be scaling, uniform scaling and non-uniform scaling. Now what mean by uniform scaling? If enlargement or reduction in the size along x-axis, both axis along x and y direction, if it is the same or equal, then it will be called as a uniform scaling. And if that changes is different along x direction and along y direction, then such scaling is called as a non-uniform scaling. Also, if scaling factors are same, then it will be called as a uniform scaling. And if scaling factors are different, then it is called as a non-uniform scaling. So scaling about origin can be achieved by metric transformation as P dash is equal to P into S. Just like for rotation, P dash is equal to P into R. For translation, P dash is equal to P plus T. Similarly, for scaling, P dash is equal to P into S, where S is the scaling transformation matrix represented as a SX 0 0 SY. Okay, so this is called as a scaling transformation matrix, 2 row 2 column. So this is a new position of scaled geometry x dash y dash. This is the original position matrix for the geometry xy, and this is multiplication of scaling matrix with original matrix, where SX is what? Scale factor in x direction, and SY is what? Scale factor in y direction. Next, the values of SX and SY. The values of SX and SY are greater than 1 increases the size of object. Means if in problem statement SX and SY are greater than 1, then it will enlarge in the size of the object, or it will increase the size of the object, and object will move away from the origin. Object will move away from the origin, where when the values of the scaling factors are less than 1, then the size of the object will reduces or decreases. Means what? In problem statement, if you find SX and SY greater than 1, then automatically when you perform the scaling transformation operation, the size of the object goes on increasing and object will move away from the origin. And if you observe scaling factors SX and SY less than 1, then the size of the object reduces and it will move towards the origin. Now for example, here in figure A 1.6.1, in figure A, what you observed, scaling factors SX and SY are 2. SX and SY are 2. So this is your original geometry, triangle ABC. This is a new geometry, scaled geometry, or it is called as a scaled triangle A dash, B dash, C dash. Means when we using the scaling factors 2, means it is a greater than 1. So the scaled geometry has a larger size than original geometry. Scaled geometry has a larger size than original geometry. Okay. Then now if scaling factors are same, uniform, 2, here SX equal to SY is equal to 2, means it will be uniform scaling along x direction and along y direction. It will uniformly increases or decreases size of the geometry. Whereas in 1.6.1b, in this figure, SX is equal to 1 and SY is equal to 2 is given. So you can observe this type of scaling is a non-uniform scaling. Along x direction it is a less scaled, along y direction it is a more scaled. Means as the scaling factor is 2 in y direction, so it will be enlarged along y direction quite larger than along x direction. Means if scaling factors are same, then there will be uniform enlargement or reduction in geometry. Now in this case, both the scaling factors are greater than 1, means the size of the object goes on increasing. Sometimes scaling factors are less than 1, means it will be 0.5. Again, in that case, the size of the object goes on decreasing. If it is less than 1, if it is a Sx equal to Sy equal to 0.5, it is a uniform scaling as scaling factors are same, 0.5, 0.5 and less than 1. So that will be the uniform scaling reduction in size. If Sx is equal to 0.5 and Sy is equal to 0.6, then it is a again reduction in size as scaling factors are less than 1, but scaling factors are different. Sx is 0.5 and Sy is 0.6, means it is a non-uniform scaling. Means if scaling factors Sx and Sy, if it is the same then or equal, it is called as a uniform scaling. Though it is a less than 1, though it is a greater than 1, it will be the uniform scaling. If a scaling factors are different, then it will be non-uniform scaling. Though it is a less than 1, greater than 1. If it is a less than 1, size of the geometry reduces. If it is greater than 1, size of the geometry increases. This is a scaling transformation operation, third one. The objective of this transformation operation is to enlarge or reduce the size of the geometry, and it is given as a P dash is equal to P plus S. Now every equation is in the form of a point. If it is a line, then it will be A dash B dash is equal to AB into S. If it is a triangle, A dash B dash C dash is equal to ABC into S. If it is a rectangle, A dash B dash C dash D dash is equal to ABCD into S. Depending on a geometry mentioned in the problem statement, you have to use equation for that particular operation. If it is a translation, P dash is equal to P plus T. If it is a rotation, P dash is equal to P into R. If it is a scaling, P dash is equal to P into S. So up to today, we learn what is meant by rotation transformation operation and how it will be performed. Then one problem on that. Then scaling transformation operation. What is the purpose of scaling? So three transformation operation we learn in geometric transformation for two dimensional transformation. Okay, this is for 2D. For 3D again, same transformation operations are there. Only one coordinate goes on increasing. If it is a 2D, then it will be x1, x and y, and new position represented by x dash y dash. If it is a three dimensional, then there will be a x, y, z. So new position of a point is given as a x dash y dash z dash.